Video 2. Brake system bleeding. Disc brake system bleeding. Tools. In order to bleed our disc brake system, the following tools are required. A Torx 25 key to open the bleeding port bolt, our Rotor Uno brake system bleeding kit, which includes all small parts, Magura Royal Blood mineral oil, and a set of syringes. An 8mm open wrench to tighten the syringes. Use safety goggles and gloves when you're bleeding our Rotor Uno disc brake system. Preparation. Our Uno group set arrives pre-bled. After connecting the brake, check if air has been trapped inside during the routing and assembly process. Remove the wheel to have clear access to the brake caliper and to avoid contamination of the disc. Remove the pad retainer bolt with a Torx 25 key. Remove the brake pads from the calipers to prevent them from contamination with oil. Use our transportation device to block the cylinders from popping out during the bleeding process. Fill the syringe with Magura Royal Blood mineral oil. Fill the Rotor Brake Bleeding Kit syringe with mineral oil. Ensure you have as little air as possible in the syringe. Bleeding. Carefully open the bleeding port bolt with a 3mm hex key. Connect the Rotor Brake Bleeding Kit syringe to the caliper. Hand tighten the syringe with an 8mm open wrench. Make a small hole in the second syringe to allow air to escape during the bleeding process. Insert the second Rotor Brake Bleeding Kit syringe straight into the bleeding port. Flush the brake system from the caliper up to the shifters to allow trapped air to come out. Pump back mineral oil from the shifter downwards to the caliper. Repeat these steps until air bubbles are no longer coming out of the system. Cover the hole in the syringe connected to the shifter. Remove the syringes from the shifter. Tighten the plastic bleeding bolt on the bleeding port to 0.5 Nm with a Torx 25 key. Repeat these steps with the rear brake system. It may be necessary to repeat the steps more times due to the longer hose and routing in the frame. Check. Check the brake system for functionality. Remove the transport device from the caliper and install brake pads using the corresponding tool. Install the wheel and check the brake functionality once again. The rear brake caliper follows the same steps as the front brake caliper. Rim brake system bleeding. Tools. In order to bleed our rim brake system bleeding, the following tools are required. A Torx 25 key to open the bleeding port bolt, our Rotor Uno brake system bleeding kit, which includes all small parts, Magura Royal Blood mineral oil, and a set of syringes. Preparation. Our Uno group set arrives pre-bled. Check the brake after connecting, just in case air was trapped inside during the routing and assembly process. Remove the wheel and brake pads to have clear access to the rim brake caliper and to avoid contamination of brake pads and rim. Fill the Rotor Brake Bleeding Kit syringe with Magura Royal Blood mineral oil. Make sure there is as little air as possible in the syringe. Bleeding. Place the brake caliper in an easy-to-access position. Completely open the quick release. Open the bleeding port bolt carefully with a Torx 25 key. Connect the syringe directly to the rear brake caliper. In Insert the second rotor brake bleeding kit syringe straight into the bleeding port. Remember to put a little hole in the second syringe to allow air to escape during the bleeding process. Flush the syringe from the caliper up to the shifters to allow trapped air bubbles to escape. Pump back mineral oil from the shifter downwards to the caliper. Activate the lever during flushing to push the remaining air outside the brave system. Repeat these steps until air bubbles are no longer coming out of the system. It may be necessary to repeat the steps more times due to the longer hose and routing in the frame. Cover the hole in the syringe connected to the shifter. Remove the syringes from the shifter. Tighten the plastic bleeding bolt on the bleeding port to 0.5 Newton meters with a Torx 25 key. Repeat these steps also with the front brake system. Check. Check the brake system for functionality by activating the rear brake lever. Install the wheel and check the brake functionality once again. The front brake caliper follows the same steps as the rear brake caliper. Thanks for watching. This concludes Video 2, Brake System Bleeding. Check out Video 3 for Shift System Bleeding.